إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله Happy witness that there is no worthy of worship except Allah. He is the one without any partner, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his last servant and his servant and his last messenger. Alhamdulillah, we continue inshallah in our lectures, our topics, and we remind each other about the deeds of the deeds that brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today inshallah we start our lecture with this beautiful and amazing, tremendous story, story of Rabi'ah, al-Aslami, who is ismuhu Rabi'ah ibn Ka'b al-Aslami, radiyallahu anhu arda'ah, kana min fuqara' al-Madina, radiyallahu anhu. فسبحان الله ربيعة رضي الله عنه يعني كان يخدم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تطوع هكذا طوع نفسه لخدمة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال كنت أبيت عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فأحرس له بابه فإن تحرك الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم لقضاء حاجته كان ربيعة يذهب ويجهز له الماء والسواك ويخدمه في الليل ويحرسه ففي يوم من الأيام قال له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سل يا ربيعة أعطك سل يا ربيعة فقال ربيعة رضي الله عنه لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ويا لها من إجابة رجال هممهم كالجبال يعني هو يعمل كل هذه الخدمة خدمة ليل لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما هي رغبته في ذلك هل رغبته الدنيا هل رغبته مدح الناس له ومدح الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم له لا هذا الرجل همه الآخرة الهمه الآخرة فرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال له سل يا ربيعة قال أريد مرافقتك في الجنة أريد مرافقتك في الجنة قال أو غير ذلك رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أو غير ذلك قال هو ذاك أو غير ذلك هو ذاك فقال له الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أعني على نفسك على كثرة السجود فهذا دليل أن كثرة السجود أي كثرة الصلاة تقرب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى بل ترفعك إلى أعلى عليين بل تجعلك في مرافقة نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم في الجنة أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يجعلنا من المصلين أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يجعلنا من الساجدين كثيرا له. So today we start with the story of Rabi'ah. He's amazing. This man, Allahu Akbar. He's amazing man. This Sahabi, companion of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's poor. He has nothing. He has nothing. To the extent that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when they ask him, he said to him, you don't want to get married, or Rabi'ah? He said, I don't have nothing. I don't have no anything to offer for my wife. I don't have nothing. I don't have no job. I don't have nothing. Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, go to the family of so and ask them. Tell them, Rasulullah, send me to marry your daughter. And he went and they gave him and they being very generous with him. They said, we are not going to return somebody that Rasulullah sent him to us. They married him, their daughter, and they've been generous with him, and they didn't ask him from anything. So he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, man, these people, like, I don't know, like, they're very, you know, generous with me. They give me whatever, but I need to give them some mahar. I don't have the dowry for their daughter. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he collected some gold for him, you know, from his companions. And then that's how Rabi'a is. He doesn't have no... He came and he used to stay and learn. Student of knowledge. He used to learn with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during the day. Night shift, he used to go and serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No job, no money. He's poor. One of the poorest of the people of As-Saffa. Those who are sitting on the sofa. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves this sahabi so much. He loves him so much. Why? Because this sahabi, he served Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for whatever that he needs. Free service. Allahu Akbar. And at night he used to guard night shift security in front of the door of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And plus that, you know, like back home, earlier before, like we have the houses, the rooms and the fence around the house. From the fence you can see what's going on in there, but you cannot see what's going inside the room. But you can see, you know, the yard. And so he said, look, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he moved or he needs something, I go and serve him. I go help him with the water, get him the water for the wudu, get him the siwak, and help him at night. So one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, he said, oh Rabi'a, ask from anything. Ask me from anything, I will make it happen for you. Allahu Akbar. With his dua, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he made dua, his dua is accepted. Is if he asked the Sahaba to do whatever, they can do it for Rabi'a. So he said to him, ask. Allahu Akbar. If I'm in the shoes of Rabi'a, subhanAllah, what I'm going to ask from? A house, a wife, place I can stay and, you know, I ask from, subhanAllah, these are, everybody can, you know, somebody doesn't have no house, doesn't have no wife, doesn't have nothing. But imagine Rabi'a radiallahu anhu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ask me from anything, I will make it happen. Do you think what Rabi'a radiallahu anhu said? He didn't ask from anything from this worldly life. Allahu Akbar. Because that's not his intention. And that's what he's looking for. He's not looking for somebody to praise him. He doesn't look for anything. He doesn't look for anything from the players of this worldly life. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, ask. He said, أريد مرافقتك في الجنة. He said, I want your company in Jannah, Ya Rasulullah. Allahu Akbar. I want your company in Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, anything else? Ask him anything. Anything else? He said, huwa dhak. That's it. Anything else? That's it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he wants him to ask from something. Something that he can, you know, help him here. He said, no. I want your company in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. That's what I'm looking for. أريد مرافقتك في الجنة. Look at this Sahaba, how love they have Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like that? Do you want to be in Jannah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you want to be a companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah, Sahabi min Sahabat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam في الجنة? So you do what Rasulullah sallallahu told Rabi'a. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, do you want to be my company in Jannah? أعني على نفسك بكثرة السجود. Help me out against yourself with a lot of prostration. That's the key to Al-Jannah. More you make sujood, more Allah will lift you up. More you make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more you bow down and you put your forehead down, Allahul A'la, He will lift you up. Subhanallah. A'inni ala nafsika bikathrati sujood. That means you have to pray a lot. You know, you have to pray a lot to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to be in Jannah? Do you want to be closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you want to be in the higher level? More sujood. Make a lot of sujood. Make a lot of salah. Be amongst al-musalleen. Be amongst those who are prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot. You will be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-Jannah. Allahu Akbar. That's the key. And then we jumped to the other hadith. Hadith Mu'adh bin Jabal radiallahu anhu. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا مُعَاذ. What makes you know about Mu'adh? Mu'adh bin Jabal radiallahu anhu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves Mu'adh so much. One day he said to him, Ya Mu'adh, إِنِّي أُحِبُّكَ فِي اللَّهِ. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah tell you, I love you. I love you so and so. Allahu Akbar. So Rasulullah told Mu'adh, I love you, Ya Mu'adh. I love you, O Mu'adh. لا تدعن دبر كل صلاة أن تقول اللهم أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. O Mu'adh, do not leave your place of the salah. After every salah, do not leave or do not stop after every salah. To say, O Allah, help me to remember you, thank you, and worship you perfectly. He taught him that dua. Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Try to memorize this dua in Arabic or in English. After every salah, you say, O Allah, help me to remember you, thank you, and worship you perfectly. So Mu'adh bin Jabal radiallahu anhu, he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day. He said, Ya Rasulullah, akhbirni an amalin yuqarribini min al-jannah wa yubaidani an-nar. O Messenger of Allah, tell me about an action that brings me closer to al-jannah and cause me to enter al-jannah or yudkhilini al-jannah. In the other narration, دلني على عمل يدخلني الجنة. Tell me about a deed or action that caused me to enter al-Jannah and take me away from the hellfire. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم قال له لقد سألت عن عظيم وإنه ليسير لما يسره الله سبحانه وتعالى عليه. You ask from something greater. Something really great, something not easy. But it will be easy for those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for them. Allahu Akbar. You ask from something, you ask from what? Something will enter you al-Jannah, take you from the hellfire. That's all, that's the whole thing. That's all what you are asking about. One Sahabi, he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I don't know what you guys saying, you and Mu'adh, like, You say a lot of dhikr, a lot of dua. I don't know what to say. What you guys say? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, what do you say when you remember Allah? When you call Allah, when you make dua? He said, I ask Allah from al-Jannah and I ask him to refuge me from the hellfire. So he said, حواليها ندندن. Around it, all our worships is around this purpose. All our remembers of Allah, all our dua is around what? Around this purpose. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fi al-akhirati hasanatan wa qina azaban nar. O Allah, give us good in this life and good in the hereafter, that is Jannah, and save us from the punishment of the hellfire. So that's what Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Mu'adh, is something great, but it's easy. Allah, if for those Allah makes it easy for them. And then he told him, you worship Allah and you do not associate any partner with him. You establish the salah, you fast the month of Ramadan, and you perform, and you pay the zakah, the charity, and you do hajj, you go to hajj, if you're able to do so. And then he told him, أَلَا أَدُلُّكَ عَلَىٰ أَبْوَابِ الْخَيْرِ. Am I direct you or tell you about the gates of goodness, means of goodness, أَبْوَابِ الْخَيْرِ. Am I tell you of the gates of good or goodness? He said, Ya Bala Ya Rasulullah. He said to him, As-sawmu junnah. As-sawmu junnah. Was-sadaqa tutfi'u al-khati'a kama yutfi'u al-nar, yutfi'u al-ma' al-nar. Wa-salatu al-rajul fi jawfi al-layl. And then he told him, am I tell you the gates of goodness? He said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. He said to him, As-sawmu junnah. Fasting is protection. Shield for you. Shield. Fasting is a protection and shield for you. Allahu Akbar. Was-sadaqa tutfi'u al-khati'a. Charity extinguishes الخطيئة, the sin. The charity you give extinguishes the sin. Like the water extinguishes the fire. Allahu Akbar. Sadaqa remove the heat. The heat and the punishment and the anger of Allah. Sadaqa removes all the evil, bad consequences of the sin. You know, my brothers and sisters, the sin, we call it dhamb in Arabic. In Arabic, dhamb. And what dhamb came from? The tail. You know that when you commit the sin, your sin is going to follow you like your tail. And then there's always bad, evil, you know, consequences. Oh. Until you say astaghfirullah, you make tawbah, and then that tail will be, the sin will go, will be cut off. Until you pay sadaqah, the sin will leave you. Allahu Akbar. You make dua, you make tawbah, you make sadaqah. So maybe you pay something for the sake of Allah. You give sadaqah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Huh? Especially when you do it in secret. You do it in secret. Like you pay sadaqah only with you and, you know, like you do it with your right hand, even your left hand doesn't know what you spend. You do it secretly. Allah, that will, what? Will cool down the anger of Allah, extinguishing the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cool down the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said to him, as-sadaqa, and he said to him, what? As-sawmu junnah. Fasting is protection. So you are fasting, even in the month of Ramadan or outside of the month of Ramadan. You know, you fast in the month of Ramadan or outside of the month of Ramadan. Same fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. As we know the blessings of the month of Ramadan, we talked about it before, but fasting in general is a shield, protection for you from any evil. From any evil. A protection for you from committing sins. Protection for you from any evil that comes to you. You are fasting, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you from coronavirus while you're fasting, and after, inshallah, you make dua and your dua will be acceptable, inshallah. You know, and it's a shield, protection for you. Subhanallah, I was reciting Quran on somebody who is sick, possessed by jinn today. And subhanallah, the jinn was screaming. He said about the sister he possessing her, the jinn was saying, she's punishing me. She's punishing me with a lot of fasting because she keep fasting. So this sister, like, she's fasting every Monday and Thursday, or maybe fasting, subhanallah. So it's a shield, protection for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you with fasting. So don't waste. I'm talking about pure fasting. Not the fasting that mixed with a lot of, you are fasting and you're committing sins. You're fasting, you're saying wrong things or, you know, or lies or something, or listening to haram things. You're fasting and you are spending your time not remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to leave all these things and keep your fasting pure. Your fasting is going to be shield and protection for you. That's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he means to Mu'az. He said to him, fasting is a shield and protection for you. And the sadaqah, so all these things has conditions. If you fulfill the conditions, it will be inshallah acceptable. And then it will serve the same reason, the purpose that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Mu'az about. So you want your fasting to be shield, fulfill the conditions of fasting. If you want your sadaqah to extinguish your, you know, your sin, like the water extinguishing the fire, you should fulfill the conditions of a sadaqah. First thing, you do it for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, you do it complete sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you try your best to do it in secret. You know, sadaqah, you can do it up in sadaqah, but it's dangerous because shaitan will come and make you like show off. But the best sadaqah that you do it in secret. Yeah. You go to somebody, you give them envelope, and then you leave. Only you and him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, somebody who needs. Or you give somebody, like in the masjid, like some, you know, you cover your hand, nobody knows, you know, you give them salam, and then you give them something on their hands. Some people, they do that, may Allah bless them. Or you go and you just put in your hand something, and then you just put it in the donation box of the masjid. And this is the best sadaqah in America here, my brothers, when you donate for the masajid of Allah, because there is no any support, there is no any help. Most of the mosques, most of the masajid in America here, they are relying on what? On the sadaqah. They rely on the charity that we give. So you go and give sadaqah in secret, that will extinguish your sin. Allahu Akbar. Like the water extinguishes the fire. Allahu Akbar. So these two things, this abwabul khair, gates of goodness that Rasulullah told Mu'az about. And then he told him, wa salatul rajul fi jawfi al-layl. Salatul rajul fi jawfi al-layl. And when we say rajul, يعني لما نقول رجل رجل وامرأة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عندما يقول رجل احنا دائما لما نذكر ونقول رجل فالنساء شقائق الرجال. So if you heard in the Quran and the Sunnah, you heard the word رجل, that means Allah subhanahu, mostly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means what? Men and women together, believers. So he said, وَصَلَاتُ الرَّجُلِ فِي جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ, and the prayer of a man in the middle of the night. Allahu Akbar. Prayer of the person, a believer, man or woman, during the night. So these three things, hold these three things tightly. Tie these three things. Al-sawmu junna, fasting. After even you finish the fast of Ramadan, you fast sunnah fasting. My brothers and sisters, Islam, just to tell you about something very important. Something that, you know, I noticed. Subhanallah, if you see all the five pillars of Islam, these are what? This fara'id, this fard, obligations. And there's sunan. Sunnah, 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 sunnah. Like, you know, sunan, you can do it after it. So it's not only to do the five times, salah and all these things. And you do the five pillars of Islam and that's it. If you want more good. So this is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Mu'az in this hadith, the five pillars, fulfill the five pillars of Islam. And then he told him about these voluntary deeds. Fasting and what? And sadaqah, give charity, and pray at night. These are the best thing after. So if we notice shahada, what's the sunnah of the shahada? What's the sunnah of the shahada? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. You should know the meaning of the shahada, and you should fulfill the obligations to do good deeds in general. قل من كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا. You do good deeds and you do not associate any partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salah, sunnah. We have sunnah salah. We have 12 rak'ah. If you pray them, like 2 rak'ah after fajr, I mean 2 rak'ah before fajr, 4 rak'ah before dhuhr, 2 after dhuhr, 2 after Maghrib, 2 after Isha, these 12 rak'ah, Allah will build you a house in Jannah. This is the sunan, you call it a sunan al-ratiba, or a sunan al-rawatib, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to do, 12 rak'ah, and he said, if you do that, Allah will build you a house in Jannah. And then you can pray another sunan, you can play more volunteer sunan, you know. And you have the fasting. What's the sunnah of the fasting? You fast every Monday and Thursday. You fast the 6 days of Ashura after you finish Ramadan. I mean the 6 days of Shawwal. We fast that one. And we fast the day of Ashura in Muharram. And then you fast every Monday and Thursday. You fast every three days every month. So you have a lot of gates of goodness. After what? After you fulfill the obligations of Allah in the Salah. You come to the zakah, you pay your zakah, you fulfill the obligation of Allah, and then you have a lot of charity. You can do a lot of charity. You can give for the sake of Allah as much as you can. Allahu Akbar. And you have what? You have fasting, and you have the Hajj. You can do the Hajj, right, one time, or, you know, whatever you're able to do so. And then you have Umrah. You can do Umrah. A lot. Allahu Akbar. And all this is what related to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Related what? To the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we come to La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, that's the best dhikr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said the best thing what I said before me and the prophets before me. La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. And you know about sending salutation, you send salah upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's the dhikr. And then when you come to the salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِكُمْ. فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمُ الصَّلَاةَ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِكُمْ. So after you finish the salah, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala standing or sitting or on your laying on your right side. Or salat al-jum'ah, after salat al-jum'ah finished, Allah said, remember Allah a lot, perhaps you may succeed. Allahu Akbar. And then when you come to the fasting of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتُكْمِلُوا الْعُدَّةَ وَتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. You finish the udda and remember Allah, glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدِ. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perhaps you may thank Allah, you may be thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Hajj, you know, you go to the Hajj, what do you say? لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. And subhanAllah and the Umrah, the same thing. So all the deeds or all the 5 pillars of Islam, the best gate or the first gate of goodness, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all these 5 pillars of Islam, it connected you with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is why we said the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is greater. وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَصْنَعُونَ. And the remembrance of Allah is greater. So that's how, and this is why we talk, when we start our lectures, we talk about what? We talk about the first thing you brings you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you confirm your lordship, when you worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تحقيق العبودية. When you confirm your عبودية to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you're servant of Allah. And if you are a servant of Allah and you are a believer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, udhkurullaha dhikran kathira, wasabbihuhu bukratan wa asila. If you are a true believer, Allah called the believers what He said, O you who believe, remember Allah excessively and glorify Him morning and night. We are nothing. We are human. We are nothing, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Wallahi, without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't have no one. Alhamdulillah that Allah is Rahim. Allah blessed us to understand that our Lord is Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Whenever you commit sin, you go to Him. You say, Ya Allah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Allah forgive me. Allah forgives your sins. Forgive your shortcomings. You're scared. You say, Allah, please protect me. Ya Allah, ahfazni. Allah will protect you. You're sad. And you say, Ya Allah, inni kuntu min al-zalimeen. Ya Allah, please relieve this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve that sadness for you. You are sick, Ya Allah, cure me. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahim. But how do we be connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? More we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More we remember Allah. اذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي الرَّخَاءِ يَذْكُرُكَ فِي الشِّدَّةِ. Remember Allah on your ease. Allah will remember you on your hardship. Allahu Akbar. Remember Allah, your ease. When you are healthy, you have time, you're free, try to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember you in your hardship. Now subhanallah, most of the Muslims, they don't worry about what happened in the world. What they say? Subhanallah, you just make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will protect you. You know, remember Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that He will protect you. Allahu Akbar. And then your heart will be very comfortable. Why? Because you have Allah. Imagine these people subhanAllah around us. They don't have Allah. They don't have nowhere. You know, they worship false gods, false deities. So when these problems they come, who they are going to call? And even if they call Allah, يَسْتَجِيبُ لَا يَسْمَعُ دُعَاءَكُمْ. When they call others, they're not going to listen to them. And when they call Allah, Allah is not going to listen to them. Why? Because they associate partner with Allah. So alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-tawheed. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this blessing and bounty of al-tawheed. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to recognize that He is our Lord. And He is the only one worthy to be worshipped. And to learn all His names and His attributes so we can make dua and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah that Allah bless us with the Quran and He bless us with the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm just looking to the time. I don't want to take much from your time. But my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, wallahi, as I'm always reminding you, more you remember Allah, more you are closer to Allah. More you are heedless from the remembrance of Allah, you are closer from the shaitan. You are closer from the shaitan. Allahu Akbar. Ask me out of experience, wallahi, my brothers. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who are al-zakirin Allah kathiran wa al-zakirat. Make us amongst those who remember Allah a lot, amongst men and women. والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أولئك أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. Those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala amongst the Muslims and believers and those who remember Allah, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah has prepared for them forgiveness. Forgiveness and great reward. The one who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he commits sin, Allah will forgive you inshaAllah ta'ala easily. And the rahmah of Allah will be closer from you. And the blessings of Allah will be closer from you because you are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But imagine you're heedless from the remember of Allah and the shaitan took you deeply in dunya. Take you deeply in your desires until you forget Allah. That caused you forget your own selves. Who are you going to call? Maybe you're going to forget about Allah, you're going to forget about the shahada and the time of your death. You're going to forget ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah and the time of your death. And you're not going to be answered the three questions of the angels. Who's your Lord? What's your religion? And who's your prophet? Allahu Akbar. But those who are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be closer for them in the hereafter and in the dunya. So that's how important, and this is why we talk always when we talk in our lectures. I remind people about what? The remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of our action related and connected with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any other thing in this world of life is being cursed. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ad-dunya mal'una, wa mal'unun ma fiha illa dhikrullah wa ma walah aw 'alimun wa muta'allim." The whole world, this dunya is being cursed. And whatever in this dunya is being cursed already. Except the remembrance of Allah and whatever that's related to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or alim, scholar who's teaching, or mutaallim, someone who's learning. Allahu Akbar. These things. So you keep yourself around these things, you will be safe. Inshallah, you will be safe. You stay away from these things and you go follow the different things. Make sure that you are following the footsteps of the shaitan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu dukhulu fis silmi kaffa ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين فإن زللتم من بعد ما جاءتكم البينات فاعلموا أن الله عزيز حكيم." Allah said, "Oh, you who believe, practice Islam completely, come to peace. Come to Silm or Islam." Some of us said Islam, that you have to come to Islam completely. You cannot half Islam. You cannot, you know, try to be Muslim, fake Muslim. Or you cannot try to be like, you know, to take part of the Islam and leave the other. You cannot take part of the Sunnah and leave the other. You cannot take part of the direction of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever that goes with your desires, and leave the others. No, completely. And do not follow the footsteps. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that? Because if you don't practice the Islam completely, that Allah completed for you, any way, you're going to follow the footsteps of the shaitan. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what? Practice Islam completely. That's the protection here. And do not follow the footsteps of the shaitan. That means you go astray. إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُّبِينٌ. Because I told you, Allah told you, the Quran is your, the shaitan is your open enemy. Is your rejected enemy. Is your enemy. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. Allah said the shaitan is your enemy. So take it as an enemy. Allahu Akbar. Don't take him as a friend. Why? Because when you follow the footsteps of the shaitan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you what? If you slide it back after the clear evidences came to you, you have to know Allah is Aziz. Allah is Almighty. Hakim, all-wise, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means Allah make the way and He told us. Subhanallah. This is why we have always to think, say Alhamdulillah ala ni'matil Islam. All praise due to Allah for the ni'mah of Islam. For the ni'mah of it. Otherwise we are following different steps. We are following the footsteps of the shaitan. Otherwise maybe we're going to be shaitan's worshippers. Allahu Akbar. Yeah. Like some people, they worship the shaitan literally. Step by step, until they go bow down to the shaitan and sacrifice to the shaitan, and they believe that their Lord is the shaitan or a dajjal or whoever that, subhanallah, associating partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah protect us from that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not slide back. Why? Because the remembrance of Allah, the Islam will take you forward. It'll take you forward. The sins and following the footsteps of the shaitan, or fulfilling your own desires in only you thinking about fulfilling your desires in this dunya, like the kafirun, like the disbelievers, and you don't have any, you know, desire for the akhirah, or you forget about the akhirah. If you ask anyone who is Muslim, they say, oh yeah, I know the akhirah. But, you know, when they commit the sins, when they are with their friends, with their companions, you know, they forget about Allah, they forget about the akhirah, iyaz billah. So this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? Udkhulu fi silmi kaffa, that takes you forward. But if you slide it back, following the footsteps of the shaitan, that means you go back. Subhanallah, this is a reality, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Wallahi, nothing holds us back from the goodness. Nothing holds us back from be good and better Muslims. Nothing holds us back to be closer to Allah than our sins. The sins that we commit during the day and night. This is why we have to say, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. You want to be closer to Allah? Say, Astaghfirullah, repent from your heart. And then follow the footsteps of what? Of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Take Rasulullah as your role model. Period. And then take the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. And take the followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the scholars among the Muslims. You will be in peace and you will find your life is changed. Oh. This is why in Ramadan, keep yourself busy listening to lectures. Listen to, mashallah, now I open my Facebook, I go down, subhanAllah, I find a lot of live lectures. If I have free time, I can just listen from this sheikh to this sheikh to this sheikh, mashallah ta'ala, in this blessed month of Ramadan. You leave all these things and then you ignore all these things and you go to your games, you go to your, you know, you want to fulfill your desires. This is the whole world is fulfillment of the desires of the shaitan. This is why Allah cursed this worldly life. Allah cursed it because of fulfillment of the desires of the shaitan. وَمَا الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ So why do this is why we have to be very careful, you know. SubhanAllah, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Mu'az about these gates of goodness, do you remember them? Let's say them again. The gates of goodness that Rasulullah mentioned. After you do the five pillars of Islam, what's the three gates of goodness? As-sawmu junnah. Fasting is protection for you. As-sadaqa tutfi'u al-khati'a kama yutfi'u al-ma'u al-nar. Wa-salatu al-rajulu fi jawfi al-layl. These three gates of goodness. He said what? Fasting is protection. Sadaqah extinguishes sin like the water extinguishes fire. And then the prayer of the person, man and woman, prayer of you at night. Pray at night. Allahu Akbar. If you pray at night, that you've been blessed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah give you the chance and the energy and the desire to stand and to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at night, You are in good. You enter from the gates of goodness. Allahu Akbar. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he recited, تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ He said, and then he mentioned this ayah, Rasulullah recited this ayah to Mu'az. He said to him, their right sides, that means what? Junub, that, when we say junubahum, that means the right side. Because we're sleeping in the sunnah on the right side. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said their right sides stay away from beds, that means they stand. That means they don't sleep. You know, sunnah, you sleep on your right side. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? this like what? Divorce beds. Stay away from the beds at night. تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ from sleep at night. Why? يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا. These are the people who knows the Akhirah. People, they really know the reality of the Akhirah. Those people know the reality of Islam and Allah and His Messenger. They make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of fear and hope. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ and they spend from whatever that we have given to them. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he used to wake up at night, open his eyes to wake up, what he used to say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اللهم لك الحمد أن تقيم السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن. اللهم لك الحمد أنت نور السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن. اللهم لك الحمد أنت لك ملك السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن. الله أكبر. He used to praise Allah. Try to memorize this, inshallah. It's very easy. You can do it at night, inshallah. When you wake up, you say, what all praise due to Allah. There is none worthy of worship except you. You are Qayyim, you are the holder, protector, preserver. You are the one who take care of the heavens and the earth and whatever in them. Laka alhamd, anta nurus, you are the light of the heavens and the earth. All praise due to you. You are the possessor of the heavens and the earth. That means the owner. You are the one who owns the heavens and the earth. Imagine. You own the heavens and the earth. You have every, you owns everything. Ya Allah. And he used to say to him, Ashhadu anna wa'daka haqq. Your promise is true. And the Jannah is true. And the Nar is true. And the Nabiyeen is true. And the Prophet Muhammad is true. Allahu Akbar. I bear witness that you are the true, and your promise is true, and the Jannah is true. Al-Haq, wa wa'aduka haq, wa anna al-Jannata haq, wa al-Naru haq, wa al-Nabiyyin haq, wa Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam haq. Open his eyes, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What do you say? La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulk wa lahul hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-ali al-azim. Rabbi aghfir li. Allahu akbar. You know this. So if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said man ta'arra min al-layli faqal these words, Allah will forgive their sins. Allahu Akbar. You guess you're sleeping at night and then you woke up for some reason. On your bed. You guess you woke up and you say, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulk wa lahul hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-ali al-azim. Rabbi aghfir li. Oh Allah, forgive me. Allah forgives you. Allahu Akbar. And then if you stood up and you pray to rak'ah, you be written amongst those who are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot amongst men and women. Allahu Akbar. My brothers and sisters in Islam, our deen is beautiful. Our Islam is beautiful. Allah is the best. When you live the Islam, when you live the life of the Islam, we live the life of the Muslims. When you feel the company of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your life, you're going to be the same like the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His nafs is quit from this worldly life. He doesn't want anything. See, the dunya is running behind him. Rasulullah is asking him, what do you need? Do you want to get married? Do you want this? Do you want that? He said, no, I want your company in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst these people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. Allahumma inna nas'aluka murafaqata nabika Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fil Jannah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he used to say, Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan la yartad wa na'iman la yanfad wa murafaqata Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi Jannah al-Khuld. He used to say, oh Allah, I ask you from iman, faith, will never return, and from bounties will never cut off or never last, will never finish. And I ask you the company of your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannat al-Khuld. So this is why the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are so closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of their love to Allah and the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they keep continuously doing good deeds, the deeds that brings them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until they met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah been pleased on them and they been pleased on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Radiyallahu anhum wa radu anha. So we need to do that. Perhaps that when we die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased on us. And Allah will enter us al-Jannah with His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanakallah.